In Europe, they are banning USDT while the Philippines starts to adopt USDT fully. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world, whenever you're watching this video, welcome to the Bitcoin Family Channel. For the newcomers, my name is Didi. Today, guys, I have four amazing Bitcoin charts. I have a crypto tip. I'm talking about the news. I'm answering a question of one of the followers and ending the video again with an inspirational quote. Let's quickly jump into the news first to see what is happening in this industry to then see if that will influence the charts. As you probably all have heard, in Europe now, they are trying to ban USDT. I don't know what they want to achieve with this, because now people will start to use USDC, for example, but you know, they want to ban USDT. You can't use USDT anymore on the exchanges. A couple of exchanges is already taking the USDT pairs down from European users, but of course Blowfin is not doing this and Bybit is also still not doing this. So you can still trade safely on Blowfin and Bybit with USDT, guys. There is no issues there. You can still use them. Also, all other exchanges that are not European based are still having these pairs online, guys. Now, if you don't want to trade USDT, you can always trade USDC. The big thing though is, while Europe, the EU, is trying to ban USDT, other countries in the world do understand the power of a USDT stablecoin, like the Philippines. They now even let people pay their fees, formal, informal, and in the private sector, when it comes to employees, pay their social security fees with USDT. This is a government-run social security system, and the government is now allowing for all those people to pay their fees with USDT. USDT is being integrated in the Philippines, is being integrated in El Salvador, is being integrated in many other countries, but Europe doesn't want to embrace USDT. And of course, there is only one reason for this, because Europe wants to keep control. They don't want people to become rich. They don't want people to get control on their lives. The EU wants to have control on your life. That is why they will come with their own central bank's digital currency that you will be able to exchange your bitcoins into, so that you get stuck for life in that Europe prison. Please be aware, never use that European central bank's digital currency if it will come, because that will get you stuck in this European prison for life. You will be required to work your ass off all your life to be able to pay taxes in that European central bank's stablecoin. And yes, that stablecoin, they will be able to freeze with any reason. If you drive through a red traffic light and freeze your bank account to withdraw some funds over there, you're fine. Or, for example, if you buy too much Bacardi in a supermarket, then Europe sees it. This is becoming an alcoholic. This is not healthy. Let's freeze his account. Yes, this is the only reason why they want the central bank's digital currency to have even more control on their citizens in Europe. That is why we need to keep fighting for decentralized currencies like USDT, like USDC, like DAI, and any other stablecoin that's being built at the moment, like USDH, that is being built, for example, on the Bitcoin blockchain. There will be many, many, many alternatives against the USDT that they are now trying to ban in the EU. And again, all the world is by now adopting to cryptocurrency. Europe, nah, they want to have control. Now let's see if that news has influenced the Bitcoin price. Let's check the charts. The first chart for the day, guys, is of course this 4-hour chart. On this 4-hour chart, we can see you're finding resistance here at 63,865 level. We are still in the long. We bought over here. We're still in profit. There's no blue line crossing the white line yet. There is no huge degrees of green over here. The red line is on top though, so we are seeing a selling signal over here. So you could be selling, or you could be waiting till we close the candle down below the yellow stepping line, because sometimes we bounce from that and go up higher, and that's why sometimes you can better stay in the trade than you cash out at the moment. But if you want to take profit, that's of course also a possibility. If we zoom into the 1 hour, we can see a little bit more clear what is happening. We can see that we are trying to break this. You see, 1-2 time. Now, maybe if we're gonna break it now for the third time, yeah, you can see what I'm gonna tell you guys, then we maybe might be forming a W pattern over here. You see, this is going to go then like that, and that is what we need then. We need one more leg up to this level. And if we break that, then of course you can break that with like almost like the depth of this W pattern to a new level. And the level would take us then to, let me see, let's take this one over there on top of there, just to give you an indication, then a 65K level somewhere. So that could be something that's happening, but again, it's not clear yet. And we still need to see if that even will become a W pattern. If not, we'll go sideways a little bit more to build some structure. As you can see over here, then, you know, we create some support levels, and from there we can try to go higher again, guys. Let's see, but beautiful times to be trading. If we zoom out and we look at the daily chart, we can see that pattern that we drew a long time ago was not like valid anymore. This pattern here, maybe we can even better make it like this, this line over there, and that line like this. Yeah, make it straight, something like that, because, you know, we don't see that pattern anymore playing out. What I saw in the beginning, it's taking too long, and maybe now it's turning into a flag pattern, but also there, then it would be a really, really, really long flag pattern. I don't really consider this anymore as a flag pattern, because the pole is as long as the flag itself. So for me now, it's just a zone that we are going sideways in. We are going to go just every time. We go there to the top, we come back to the bottom, top. Here, you know, you see every time to that bottom, we try to go up again, bam, top. So it's this sideways zone where we are moving in. Not bad. Sometimes we need to go sideways to take a breath. But there is some amazing charts coming up that will show you something very explosive. Because I also know that there is some negative charts at the moment. You know, people are talking about a 2-monthly chart and a gravestone doji. Yes, that is right. But I have another vision on that chart as well that I found on Twitter. And I'm going to share this with you. RSI is again above the 30 level, which is bullish. You can see also the candles coming up again. We need to break the blue line first, then the yellow line, then the green line, and then we will go to the top again around that 70K in these amazing sideways movements. On the bottom, you can see something really interesting happening. We can see that blue line crossing that red line, which means on a daily time frame, we are creating a green bar. Now look to the left. Every time what happens, we start to create green bars. As over here, we start to create green bars, we went up. Here, we start to create green bars, we went up, but we couldn't create more. But this cross at the bottom here, at these levels, is an important cross in that MACD, and an important cross in that MACD that will mostly lead to a very bullish move. Let me see if we can go as deep as this anywhere before on the charts, just to show you what happened in the previous times we went that deep. Let me draw a line over here. Let me draw a line over here. This is where we are now. So these two times we went as deep as well. Even one time we went deeper just before that over there. Let me make it there. You can see it over there. Now, what happened in those moments? That's the question now. Now let's go back. Let's go back here. This is one of those moments that we went that deep over there. We had a huge run up from all the way here. This is like 17,000 back to 25,000. Now, the time before was over here. So we are crashing down. And then from there, 35, we went back to 47, 10K run. The time before that was here, from 30K all the way up to 60K. So yes, we can go deep, but the moment we start to cross is mostly very bullish. Short term, here we went from this level, 58, back to 70K when it happened over there. And now the blue line is crossing that red line again, which is bullish. Let's see if we can stay bullish and take these charts a little bit higher. Now, let's jump into the chart that I was talking about on the 2-monthly time frame. This is the chart, guys. This is a beautiful chart that we can see is created by the Titan of crypto. We have the 20 SMA and the 21 EMA. There's a 2-month chart, as you can see here in the top. Now, on this 2-month chart, this is the candle that everyone is talking about. This is a gravestone doji. And a gravestone doji mostly leads into a turnaround of the market. It mostly leads to a turnaround of the market. Not always, because if you look back to this moment over there, look, just before the bear market, we had a gravestone doji. We were already bearish. We went a little bit more low, but after that, we went massively up. So these gravestone doges, they are very important. It does mean, hey, we are stopping out. We had a beautiful run. We need to stop. We could see a small pullback and then go up again, but it's not necessary to have a pullback. In this chart, you can also see something very bullish. We can see this golden cross. We can see that the 21 EMA is trying to cross the 20 SMA. That blue line is trying to cross that orange line. Now, if we look back into the past, what happened every time when that blue line crossed that orange line, we can only see one time, two time, we're talking during a bull market, three time. Now, that first time that it happened, we had a massive run of almost 9,300%. The second time that we saw that golden cross, we had a run of, don't be in shock, of 2,500%. Now, the third time that we saw that cross, that blue line above that orange line, we still had a run of 404%. We see the same thing happening now again. We see that blue line crossing that orange one. What will this run be? Will it only be 100%? That will still bring us to $130,000 per Bitcoin. Will it be 110 or will it be 150%? We are reaching prices between $140,000 and $160,000 per Bitcoin. So yes, it is a chart with mixed signals. We have that gravestone doji. The next candle is being built, but we do see a golden cross of the 21 EMA and the 20 SMA, which in history has led to massive runs in that Bitcoin price. So that is exactly what Bitcoin is. For me, I believe that this gravestone doji, normally, for example, in a normal market that doesn't have a four-year cycle, would be a very important candle. At the moment, we are looking at Bitcoin. Bitcoin is not a normal asset. Bitcoin is the king of assets with a four-year cycle. No other asset before had a four-year cycle. So all these dojis, all these candlestick patterns, of course, it all has to do with TA, and of course, they all are important. But at the moment, we are in the four-year cycle, exactly in a part of the bull market, that we will go up massively in the next 12 to 18 months. So even if this doji plays out, and even if we correct a little bit, maybe even to 52K, I would still be adding, because I believe that we will see a bull market top in 2025 September. So yes, gravestone doji, but also a golden cross. I tend to lean to believe that golden cross and see another massive run in that bull market all the way into 2025. Then you get a chart like this that I also found on Twitter. It's a little bit difficult to read, but it does show you what I expect as well. So we are now having that halving over there. You know, we have this sideways movement. There will be a moment, in, I think after the summer, September-ish, that we will move up again, bam, maybe to 100K. He is expecting 15th of July. I'm expecting a little bit later that we then pull back a little bit. We go up maybe even to 120K or 100K. And it's the end of 2025. So this is all happening between July and October, he is saying. I would say December, as we normally have a top around December. Then again in January, a huge correction, as we always have that in January, February, from 120K to 84K. Everyone will think this is over, maybe even back to 70K. And from there, we start to build again all the way up into September to a new top that could be around 160K. He's thinking even higher, maybe 200K. You know, I believe 160K is already a very beautiful top. But this is the pattern that could play out. This is how it all could play out. Like sideways, up till December, crash into February, March, go up again, bam, in May, and have a beautiful run to the new Bitcoin bull market top around 150, 160K, and maybe even higher. Cool chart. I hope you really enjoyed those charts, guys. And yes, wow, beautiful short-term volatility. 61K, we went all the way to 63K. I have another trading profit. You can see it over there. beautiful profit around 15% at the moment. I will wait till it goes a little bit higher and take some profits over there. So the news did not influence the price at all. It even pumped Bitcoin, which is amazing. Thank you, the EU, for banning USDT. Maybe all those people are now exchanging USDT into Bitcoin, and that is why maybe Bitcoin is going up, guys. No, that's just a joke. Of course, it's just short-term volatility. Look at the bigger picture. Zoom out. Look what is happening. We are just on the half of this bull market. We have 12 more months to go. We need to go to the top in 2025. So we will have a beautiful summer, relax, for you to enjoy beautiful sunsets, whatever you want. Then from August, September, we will start pumping again all the way up into December. That is where you can take some profits, because we will see another dip before we go to a new all-time high bull market top in 2025, guys. So 12 more months of beautiful, beautiful bullishness, and at least 2 or 3 more months of beautiful sunrises like that one over there. Yes, you can just enjoy that. Just chill, take it easy, chill, enjoy these sunrises while Bitcoin will do what it needs to do. It will slowly go up again, go back into the shadow so you can really see my face. So I will repeat it once more again. Stop crying, start buying, don't freak out, zoom out, look at the bigger picture, understand what Bitcoin is doing, and buy each and every dip. The crypto tip for today, very short, guys. Don't worry about USDT. At the moment, USDC and EURC are both fully compliant with all the rules of the banking system, with all the rules, cryptocurrency rules for this market, guys. So yes, USDC, which is built by Circle, is fully regulated in the United States and also fully regulated now in Europe, guys, together with EURC, also European stablecoin. Those two are fully regulated by now. So all the exchanges will be able to offer these stablecoins now instead of USDT. So don't worry about USDT. I think most exchanges won't even delist USDT from their exchanges. But if there is exchanges that will do that, they will always have USDC and EURC and many other stablecoins like DAI on the exchange as well, guys. So don't be freaking out. Don't believe all the FUD. Fear, uncertainty, doubt. That is exactly what all those news agencies want to create. That's exactly what Europe wants to achieve. They want you to fear the crypto market. They want you to become uncertain about the crypto market. They want you to start to doubt about the crypto market. You know why? Because they don't want you to become rich. They don't want you to own any Bitcoins, because then you might become self-independent completely and not in the need anymore of Europe governments. That is what they don't want, but that's exactly what you should want. You should want to become independent and not dependent on the European and the European governments, because they want to keep you poor so you will just be in control. And listen, do the opposite of what those people want. Don't believe all the FUD, because that's being created by the same people that want you to believe all that FUD, to create fear, uncertainty and doubt within you. And you should never doubt Bitcoin, because Bitcoin is the king of all assets, fully decentralized, and it will be your gateway to freedom in any kind of way. So what I would say, this to the EU, this to their rules, take full control yourself by investing in Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies now. And that is how we arrive already at the end of the video, guys, the inspirational part of the video. Today, it's about life. Because life does not have any limitations, only the ones that you create. Listen to this again. Life doesn't have any limitations, only the ones that you create. It's a very important one. Please understand this one. There is no limitations to life. Everything is possible. Even the things that you expect to be impossible, even those are possible. Everything is possible. The only limitations that you see are the ones that you create in between your ears. That's your limitations of thinking. You're creating those. And not even you, it's probably those two voices in your head that are creating these. those two voices that are like debating every time with each other, when you want to make a choice, when you want to decide on something, no, yes, no, yes, the good things, the bad things, these are creating your limitations in a world that is completely unlimited. Why would you accept it? Just please do this exercise. Whenever you find yourself discussing within your head, no, yes, no, yes, you don't know how to make up your mind, just pretend that you are not one of those two voices, but you lean back. You're leaning back in this beautiful gaming chair, and you're just observing those two voices leading their discussion. In the end, you will choose which voice to follow. You are not those voices. This is something built in your brain, I think because of schooling, because of educating you in a way that you need to be inside a box. You don't think free anymore. You think about a limited world, not an unlimited world with possibilities. So those voices are trained to do that. You are a different person. You are there sitting back in your gaming chair like this. And you're like, what are they discussing about? What are they talking about? And in the end, you will choose yourself what you want to do. And then you will slowly understand you have been boxed in into this box of beliefs, of feelings, of ideas. The moment you start to understand that everything is possible in life, that there is no limit to life, that is the moment when you will be able to make choices that support those unlimited possibilities. The moment you live inside this box of ideas and values and norms creating by governments and schools into your brain, that is the moment when you will live in limits. That is the moment when you will never step outside that box. That's the moment when you will be satisfied with something that you think that would be the top of your life. There is always a better top. There is always a higher top. There is always more possibilities. There is an unlimited amount of possibilities to your life. You can do whatever you want. It is only you that is creating these limitations because you're educated to do so. There is no limitations to life. Even right now, on this certain moment, you're watching my video. When you end watching this video, give the video, of course, a thumbs up. And then go do something completely different that you were planning to do. And then an hour later, analyze that situation. You did something that you didn't plan. You did something completely different that you didn't expect. Maybe something that you didn't even think that would be possible on this day. But it was, and you did it. That's how you, by small changes to your daily routine, you start to understand that there is an unlimited possibilities in your life. It is not about all those things that you think that is the max. There is way more potential within you. There's way more capacity in you. There's way more strength in you. There is way more dreams that you can pursue the moment you start to understand that there is no limits to life. There is no limits to life. I hope you really enjoyed today's video. If you did enjoy today's video, then please give it a thumbs up, share with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, leave a comment. What did you think again about the charts, the tips, and everything else? Thanks for watching. I wish you an amazing day and see you tomorrow again. For all the Dutch people, good luck tonight. Yes, we are going to win. We are going to win from Romania.